that I've opened up again. It's got two of everything in it. So we pull these out. And this is one that we'd use for an environment that would be damp or outside. And as I look at the packet here, it gives me an IP rating of IP66. And you notice now it's a 20S. So the hole in which I need to knock out into a box will be 20, and the gland is a 20 mil diameter, but it's the S, so that means small. This is the one we'd call a CW gland, used for a damp environment. We come with two shrouds. We already know that these are not banjos, they're earthing rings. And let's look at breaking down what we've got here. So as I open this one up, this is our sealing nut. And you can just see in there, hopefully, a little black seal that will need to seal around the cable. So that's our sealing nut. We've got a gland body now, as we had before. So we've got a gland body. Unscrew that, and remember, there's two of everything in each pack. So that's our sealing nut, gland body. They go together, and you notice something drop out there. This is different now. We've got this here. We've got, again, they're all in brass. This is our compression ring, and that goes onto our gland body. And again, we've got a locking nut, but you notice now that we've got a smooth area around here where with the knurling before. So what happens there is this ring, this brass ring, traps our armour in onto our gland body. So it's probably easier for me to show you that with this one here. So again, this is a CW gland semi onto a steel bar armoured cable. We've got our sealing nut with our plastic seal inside there to seal against the outside PVC to prevent the ingress of moisture. We've got a gland body that when we push it up, we'll push our brass ring onto our steel wire armoured. So as I push that one forward, we can see that that would then be locked off onto our gland body. And then when we pull them together, okay, we tighten that one off, we bring up our nut here. So our sealing nut comes up. And if I just pull it to the side, you can see now, once we tighten it up, hopefully the PVC in there will seal around. So when we looked in there, we saw that black PVC sealing would seal against the outside of the cable to maintain its IP rating. So that's our CW gland. Now it might be you're really fortunate you level up once again. So in the college, you're likely to working with a BW 20, 20S gland. You might use the CW ones if you're ever stretching exercise. But then when we get onto site, you might have a purpose built gland for outside environments, okay? So if you look here, this gland here has an IP rating of IP68, okay? So we'll have a quick look at this style of gland. So when I get this one out, it'll reiterate another point that we need when we do glands for outside use. So again, two 20 mil lock nuts, okay? So we're happy with those. Two earthing rings, okay, come in those. And no shrouds in this set. Okay, but what we have got is this gland body made up very similar to the CW gland we just saw. So we've got effectively our sealing nut, and you see in there again, there is a seal in there, a little O-ring in there as a seal. Okay, then we've got our gland body, very similar to what we saw, but obviously these are not brass. The brass gland is held within there, and again, we've got a compression ring and our gland body. So similar to what we just saw in a CW gland, but obviously it's a slightly different design for those. Now these are great. Obviously in college, these are quite, they're quite expensive for a college to be using. And obviously as they're plastic, and again, when using a pair of grips or spanners on them, it can damage the PVC. Remember, a gland's probably only ever gonna be installed once in its life, whereas at college, you're taking them in and out. The important bit here is because it wants to be IP rated, you notice we have another O-ring or another seal here actually as it goes into our enclosure. So that needs to be there and sealed. So imagine that was going into a box, obviously, and clamped in there. The seal would need to be in place in order to keep that IP rating. So if we go back to our CW gland, there would need to be a seal here that would need to be added by the electrician. And that's often forgotten. Obviously, we've sealed it here. We've gone into our enclosure, but between the enclosure and the gland body, as we have here, you'd need some sort of O-ring seal in order to maintain that IP rating. And again, it might be if you're using a box outside. Obviously, this is a insulated box. Okay, in order to go in there, you notice the holes are pre-punched into it as well. In our college setting, we tend to use either galvanized or black enamel boxes inside. And then we're thinking about maintaining the protective conductor. So we're going to bring the CPC off the armouring. So this armouring within the cable needs to be connected to the protective conductor. So if we open this one back out, At one end, if you're not using it as a CPC, so you could be not using this as a CPC, and we'll look at that in another video, but if you are using the steel wire armoured as a CPC, it's obviously going to earth to the gland body, and that's where our earthing ring can bring through the protective conductor into our enclosure. And we've seen that in a previous video where we made off steel wire armoured. So the armouring needs to be maintained if we're going to use it as our CPC. If we're not going to use it as a CPC and we're going to use one of the cores, which is also fine, because this is electrical and metal, it is an exposed conductive part and it will need earthing from at least one end. So you can't get away with not earthing our steel wire armoured because it is an exposed conductive part.